Yeah, actually, that scenario is very common among parents.
Yes.
Very common siya. Kasi nakikita ko siya sa financial planning sessions ko where kapag rini-review ko yung policies ng clients ko, meron silang single-pay VUL for their children. Tapos nung tinatanong ko, para saan to, sinasabi nila, investment siya for their children, pang pamana na nila, para sa anak nila. So, hello everyone!
Hello, hi! And kamusta kayong lahat? Ayan.
So, welcome again to a new episode of Wealth Arki. So, yes. Naka-quarantine pa rin, as you can see. Zoom lang tayo or ano, streaming service.
StreamYard ang gamit natin, yes.
Yes. So, again, for this week, we have a special episode, no? So, we'll be discussing what a single-pay VUL is because in our previous episode where we talked about misconceptions about life insurance, we discussed that there are a lot of regular pay VULs in the market, but hindi masyado na didiscuss kung ano yung single pay VUL. So ngayon, i-discuss natin siya. But yes, if you want to see, but if you want to check out the video where we discuss the misconceptions of life insurance, you can video link in the description below. So check it out. Sige.
Yes.
So
kasi ano eh hindi lahat aware tungkol sa existence ng SPVUL, which is single pay VUL. And usually din kasi ang ino-offer ng mga agents ay VUL or in some cases yung whole life insurance, or term life insurance. May mga special needs kasi na ang best na sagot ay SPVUL, no, for them. Mm-hmm. And of course, before we discuss yung mga benefits and all, and para kanino ba talaga ang SPVUL, siguro pwede mong sabihin muna, ano ba talaga yung single pay VUL? What is it exactly?
Sige. A single pay VUL is actually a one-time pay of a VUL. So it's still a VUL, my life insurance and investment. But comparing it to a regular pay VUL, you only pay it one time. So you can think of it as a lump sum investment.
Okay.
So ano yung focus ng single pay VUL compared to a regular pay VUL? Actually, since it's only a one-time payment, so it's meant to preserve your wealth. And it's actually meant for wealth accumulation. The reason for this is mas mababa yung charges compared to regular pay VUL. Usually, it's just 1%, 5%. And then that's
talaga.
So, tapos, at some point, mawawala yung charges.
Okay, so para siyang ano, para siyang yung regular na VUL, except that are you saying na instead of me paying monthly or me paying annually, one-time payment lang ang gagawin ko sa umpisa.
One-time payment lang.
After ko magbayad, good for how long yung ano, yung policy, kasi 'di ba may mga VUL na hanggang age 99, let's say yung life insurance coverage. So, ang life insurance coverage ng SPVUL, hanggang anong age or ilang years siya?
So, that's a good question, no? Because usually with single-pay VULs, it's a company-to-company basis. So, for example, there are single-pay VULs na hanggang age 100 yung life cover niya. Meron namang ibang single-pay VULs na age 88.
Mm-hmm.
So, it really depends on the company at yung product design kung hanggang kailan yung insurance cover mo.
Ah, okay. Pero yung investment part naman, sa regular pay VUL, syempre, di ba, may cash value yung investment. And more often than not, after mga 5 years or more, dun para nagkakaroon ng significant value yung investment part. Sa single pay VUL, since one-time payment siya, yung investment part ba niya, usually, ilang years bago mo makita na meron siyang significant na growth?
Yeah. Actually, yun yung always na tinatanong sa life insurance agent regarding single-pay VUL. Regarding that, it really depends on the performance ng fund.
Yeah.
Because, for example, balance fund siya, tapos one-time payment ka lang. So, timing the market becomes really, really important. Diba? Mm-hmm. Because if, let's say, pumasok ka at high, tapos 5 years from now, let's say, bumaba siya, of course, bumaba din siya. But if, let's say, tumaas din siya, of course, tumaas din siya. So, it really depends on the performance ng market and, of course, the performance ng fund.
So, yeah, like, but given the situation na, kunwari, kumuha ko ng SPVUL ngayon, tapos biglang tumaas yung stock market at nasa equity fund siya. So, I can expect na next year, mataas na rin yung cash value nung SPVUL ko, nung investment part?
Mm-hmm. Given that assumption, yes. Because wala kasing charges.
Kasi 5%. Pag ang kinuha mo regular pay na VUL ngayon, tapos umakit yung stock market next year, pag tinanong ko yung cash value nung investment part ko nung regular pay VUL ko, usually maliit pa rin eh. Kasi
yeah, maliit pa rin.
Malaki yung kinukuha na portion papunta sa insurance part during the first few years ng regular pay VUL. Pero sa SPVUL, konti lang yung kinukuha papunta sa insurance, tama ba?
Yes.
And a large part goes to the investment.
Investment, yeah. Because yung purpose kasi ng single pay VUL is really meant for investment purposes. In fact, yung insurance coverage niya is just 25% of the face amount. Ay, sorry, of the premium.
125%, tama ba, di ba? Or 25%?
Ay, let's give an example. So, halimbawa, because yung minimum kasi ng mga single pay VUL, 100,000 pesos yung bagsak.
Okay, so kunwari kumuha ako ng 100,000 na SPVUL, ang life insurance death benefit ng makukuha ay magkano?
Usually 25,000 lang.
Ah, hindi ba 125,000?
Depende pa rin sa company. So if may ibang companies na kasama yung fund value and life insurance cover, so magiging 125. But meron din kasing ibang companies na either life insurance cover or yung fund value. So kapag yung fund value mo is greater than the life insurance cover, fund value pa rin yung ibabalik.
Ah, okay. Sige. Parang iba kasi yung naririnig ko na yung for the first, as long as the fund value is lower than dun sa binigay mo, parang 125% yung makukuha mo. I guess that depends on the product.
Yeah, it depends on the product because may case kasi ako na single pay VUL yung nakuha niya. But upon review, meron kasi benefits table. Nakikita kasi na puro fund value lang yung nakalagay doon because it's greater than the life insurance cover. So if in case something happens to you, babalik talaga yung fund value sa client. Kaya maraming tao parang gearing towards single pay VUL dahil less hassle, hindi na nila problemahin yung payments, tapos guaranteed yung investment amount because wala na masyadong charges.
Adriel, bakit ang naalala ko kasi isa sa mga single pay VUL niyo yung Sun MaxiLink 1?
Yeah. Ano ba?
Oo. I remember a presentation sa akin na 125% yung makukuha mo, tama ba? Kasi parang 125% of the single premium paid assuming no withdrawals are made or the fund value which is higher.
Yeah.
Can you check? Baka mamaya mali yun.
Actually, tama ka because first and life usually combined kasi yung fund value and face amount. So, yung 125% dyan, yun kasi yung fund value and the face amount. So, combined na siya. So, if I put in 100,000 pesos, di ba, and the insurance cover is 25,000, if something happens to me along the way, my beneficiaries will be given the 125,000 pesos. Hindi yung 100,000 lang. Yun yung ibig yung sabihin.
Ah, okay. So maganda na na-breakdown natin yon kasi yeah. I've been listening to presentations of different insurance companies and yun lang yung sinasabi nila. Kung magkano yung nilagay mo, ang death benefit mo is 125% nung nilagay mo. So, or if the fund value is already higher than that, then yun yung makukuha. So kung tumaas yung investment mo tapos yung investment part naging 150,000 yung value, yun na yung makukuha mo, hindi 125,000 lang.
Yeah. And another advantage then with the single pay VUL is what we have the concept of guaranteed insurability option or GIO. It's actually the option for clients to increase their level of cover without going through a medical or yung medical exam. Ibig sabihin, if let's say I put in 5M, tapos yung medical limit is just 4M, pwede siya through GIO dahil may separate limits din siya.
Pero paano yung mga tao na hindi na sinasabi nila hindi na insurable, like yung may mga alam mo, terminal illness na and all, pwede pa ba sila kumuha ng SPVUL?
It's an option, but again, mayroon pa rin underwriting limits eh. Even if guaranteed insurability option, di pa rin, di ba, di ka pa rin matatakas sa underwriting procedure ng insurance company. So if may terminal illness na yung client, it depends pa rin kung ano yung severity ng terminal illness na yun. Di ba?
So we're saying na less yung ano, less stringent yung mga ano tawag mo doon? Yung
the stringent yung requirements kapag ng single pay VUL versus yung regular pay or term. Actually, what people do and what I usually advise my clients is if you have term insurance, pwede kang kumuha ng single pay VUL as a backup. Because, di ba yung term insurance hanggang a certain period lang?
Yes,
so, if
yes.
In case mag-expire na, meron ka pa rin single pay VUL na hanggang lifetime yung cover. Tapos yun na yung gagamitin to pay estate tax, burial fees, etc.
Yes, yes.
So less hassle siya to think about. Because kapag sa regular pay VUL, parating mong isipin, oh, ano na yung investment ko, magkano pa yung babayarin ko, because you're paying it annually eh. Regular dapat yung payments para hindi siya mawala.
Mm-hmm. So, ang SPVUL ba, para siyang mutual fund investment na pwede kang mag-top up. Kunwari, kumuha ka ng 100,000 ngayon, tapos may extra 100,000 ulit ako next year. Pwede ko ba siyang idagdag doon sa existing na SPVUL ko or kukuha ulit ako ng bagong policy?
Actually, that's a very good question because in the market right now, may products na does that na parang mutual fund na pwede mag-top up.
Mm-hmm.
But meron din ibang products na hindi talaga. Because single pay VUL is really just a one-time pay VUL. So if you have an extra 100,000, tapos nakuha mo is one-time pay lang talaga, hindi pwede mag-top up. You have to get another single pay VUL.
May limit ba yan sa dami ng SPVUL na pwedeng kunin ng isang tao?
Wala naman. It just depends on the GIO limit ng agent. So if yung insurability option limits ng agent, let's say 50M, so hanggang 50M lang talaga. If it's 200 million, 200 million talaga.
Okay. So ano pa rin, no? Depende pa rin talaga sa company na kinukuhanan mo.
Yes.
At saka dun sa produkto mismo na in terms and conditions. So kasi I think may mga insurance companies na mayroon silang iba't ibang klaseng SPVUL din, no? So depende talaga kung ano yung nakalagay na benefits. Since this is also life insurance, nalalagyan din ba siya ng mga riders like mga accidental, mga hospital benefits, I don't know. Ano ba yung mga riders na pwede idagdag sa kanya on top of the typical death benefit, no?
Yeah. Actually, no, with single pay VUL, since life insurance product nga siya, tama ka, Sir Fitz. Pwede pa rin yung riders, yung critical illness benefit, yung hospital income benefit, yung accidental death, yung normal, yung common riders, pwede pa rin siya sa single pay.
Though, so, of course, mas mamahal siya? Or how does that work?
It's actually the same rate sa regular pay VUL, no? But hindi kasi siya common din na nagay sa single pay VUL because we treat it more as an investment rather than as an insurance because the charges are really low.
Mm.
Like yung first year, mga 0.004% or 5%.
Ah, talaga?
Charge. And then the following year, parang 100 pesos na lang yung charge. So, it's really meant to grow the investment portion. Because again, it's like lump sum investing. No? So, you really don't want na puro charges yung nasa single pay VUL. If you're planning to grow it to a significant amount. Actually, a sample of that was one of our videos before yung sa AXA. Yung mm-hmm. Asset Master. That's actually a good example of a single pay VUL. So if you want to check that video out, again, link in the description below.
Yeah, and yung Asset Master, ano siya eh, meron kang option na mag-invest sa mga global funds, may mga mga ano international markets na investment part, mga funds that invest in the international market doon. So, just like a usual VUL, may mga choices ka rin kung saang fund ilalagay or saang investment ilalagay?
Yes. Actually, yun kasi yung similarities ng regular pay VUL and single pay VUL. You can still have the funds. So, from money market to equity fund, it's all there. Like what we said before, some misconceptions, you have to communicate with your insurance advisor agent, ano yung purpose ng fund, ano yung purpose ng single pay VUL, at anong goal. Because if let's say medium term goal ka lang, so pwede ka na sa balance fund. But let's say for yung education fund, retirement fund, then maybe better yung index fund as long as it's 20 years, 30 years down the line.
Pero so, pwede mo pa rin siyang ilipat-lipat.
Yes, pwede pa rin mag-fund switch, pwede pa rin ano. So it really is like a mutual fund. Nakatago lang siya sa insurance.
May added benefit lang nung insurance. Ah, I see. So usually ano ba yung pinakamaliit na pwede mong kunin na SPVUL? You mentioned 100,000. Is that the lowest o may mga SPVUL na as low as 10,000? May mga ganun ba?
Ay, walang 10. Usually 100,000 yung minimum. Because lump sum investing eh. So you really have to shell out a big amount of cash or a big amount of money. Because if let's say 10,000 lang, yung cash mo ngayon, 20,000, then better siguro mag-term insurance ka na lang. Or maybe a very cheap VUL, no? Na regular pay.
How about yung maximum? Meron ba siyang maximum?
Maximum, depende pa rin yan sa agent. No, because may limits kasi tayo. Like for me, yung VIO limit ko right now is mga 100M, 200M. But if the system only allows, let's say, 50M, so 50M lang talaga.
Yung maximum na pwedeng na pwede. Hanap na lang siya na ibang agent or ibang insurance company.
If you want to diversify, kung ganon.
Ah, okay. So, let me just clarify, no? So, ang SPVUL, it's an insurance with investment, pero leaning more towards the investment part. Diba?
Yes.
And it's a lump sum, quote-unquote, investment na ang life insurance benefit mo at the most basic level is 25% of the value na nilagay mo. And of course, kapag may nangyari sa'yo, yung life insurance part will kick in and yung beneficiary mo will get 25% of the value nung nilagay mo plus the cash value nung investment part. Tama ba?
Tama. But may ibang companies na fund value na binibigay because yung product design nila, di na kukunin yung insurance amount because it's like 25% lang.
Ah, okay. Tapos, yung investment part, you can invest it in different kinds of funds, parang the usual regular pay VUL or yung mga mutual fund, na pwede rin silang mag-switch every now and then kung saan nila gusto. Tama?
Yes.
Alright. So, siguro yung pinaka-last na naisip ko is, ano ba yung mga purpose ng SPVUL? Ano yung mga scenarios na kung saan yun yung magandang kunin.
Yeah, that's a good question because again, no, yung purpose kasi ng SPVUL is meant to preserve your wealth and, mm-hmm. and of course wealth transfer ng estate taxes. So if you already have a proper insurance but you still need additional insurance, let's say for wealth transfer because yung term insurance mo is meant for the education fund or let's say to protect yung health needs ng sarili mo, then pwede yung single-pay VUL. And then, if let's say, pwede siyang maging kicker.
So yun sa yung, akin, ano eh, naisip ko sa kanya, if I have extra money that mm-hmm. I can invest, plus, I think, yun nga, sabi mo, kicker, gusto kong dagdagan yung insurance coverage ko without really going through the usual process of getting a normal life insurance. Kasi I think mas mabilis din ang transactions ng SPVUL, di ba?
Yeah, mas mabilis. Dahil konti lang kasi tatanungin mo sa iyo kung SPVUL. And yeah, it would actually bypass the regular underwriting process.
So mas maganda na SPVUL na lang yung kunin if I just want to add a little bit more coverage on my part, plus I have extra money that I can invest. Also, another scenario na usually nire-recommend ko personally ang SPVUL is yung pang estate planning or wealth preservation. For example, matanda na, sabi natin 55 years old or mag-retire na, and then they want some money for estate planning, yung of course pambayad ng mga na estate taxes ng mga kamag-anak niya pag may mangyari sa kanya. So an SPVUL becomes a good option for those people, no?
Yeah, I agree, because at least covered ka to certain amount, and in case something happens to you, let's say 80 ka na, 88, for sure mas mataas na yung fund value versus when you got it. And that fund value can be used to pay yung estate taxes because estate laws change every now and then. So yun.
So meron akong scenario sa'yo kasi may na-meet ako na mag-asawa tapos yung pera nila, sabi nila, pag namatay sila, gusto nilang pumunta doon sa anak nila. Pero ayaw nilang magkaroon ng part yung asawa ng anak nila. Hindi ko alam for some reason kung bakit ayon. So, ang ginawa nila ay yung a lot of the money that they plan to parang give dun sa anak nila, nilagay nila sa SPVUL, tapos siya yung ginawang benefit. Di ba? Is that something na, is that, you say na it's, that's another use for an SPVUL para maibigay mo na kagad yung pera na gusto mong manahin nung isang tao o nung anak mo or whoever without really giving it to them. Kasi siyempre, iniisip din niya, nila na baka mamaya waldasin lang nung anak nila yung pera pag binigay na kagad nila. Yeah. Pero at the same time, ayaw naman din nila tawag dito, matago sa kanila kasi di ba it will be subject to estate taxes pag nasa bangko lang nila. So nilagay nila sa SPVUL para at least daw it will still make money, they still have access to it, and at the same time, anytime na mamatay sila, pupunta na sa anak nila without estate taxes. Tama, no?
Yeah, actually, that scenario is very common among parents.
Yes.
Very common siya. As in, nakikita ko siya sa financial planning sessions ko where kapag rini-review ko yung policies ng clients ko, mayroon silang single-pay VUL for their children. Tapos nung tinatanong ko, para saan to, sinasabi nila, investment siya for their children, pang pamana na nila, para sa anak nila. Which is actually fine, no? But that actually, we can discuss in another video.
Yes.
Pwede ba natin i-insure yung anak natin or hindi? Because that's a common question that gets asked a lot sa wealth RP, no?
Well, ang i-insure pa rin nila yung sarili nila, tapos ang beneficiary lang is yung anak nila, no?
Yeah. Ayun. Which actually segment natin na importante pa rin yung financial planning. Because even with single-pay VUL may be good for you, but if the solution requires, let's say, a term insurance or a whole life or a health insurance, so dun tayo mag-lean. So again, we're just discussing this so that we give options for you. Though this may not be the best solution for you. Kaya importante pa rin yung financial consultation.
May kausap sila para ma-assess yung financial situation nila and yung needs nila so that they can be assured na they are getting the best fit na product para sa kanila, no?
Mm-hmm. Ayun.
Right.
Right. So medyo matagal na 25 minutes. Na.
Yes,
so I guess we can end here, no?
So maraming salamat sa inyo na nanood and of course while we are in quarantine mga pre-recorded online sessions muna tayo, but of course we have our regular live streams which I hope you are all watching and I hope everyone is safe and healthy during this time, no? So if you learn
at home,
if you learned something new sa video na to, then please give it a thumbs up and share it to your friends. And sana mag-subscribe kayo sa channel natin. So please subscribe and please hit the notification bell para meron kayong notification kapag meron tayong video. Nanonotify din sila pag meron tayong schedule ng live stream, di ba?
Yeah, naka-hit naman yung notification bell ko sa isang account ko.
Yes, oo. So I guess that's it, no? Yes. And thank you, Adriel, and thank you sa inyong lahat. So, yes, may sasabing ka ba? May final words ka, Adriel?
Stay safe, stay at home, help our frontliners, and stay healthy. Ayun.
Alright.
So, goodbye, everyone. Ingat.